Hey guys, Chelsea here from Making Manzanita, and today we are going to teach you how to install Pergo Outlast laminate flooring. So this is how our living room started. Before we started our living room makeover, I couldn't wait to get rid of that carpet. We have been working our way through our home, removing this carpet as we go and installing new flooring. So it was definitely time for this carpet to go in the living room. So we have a whole separate video coming on how to remove the carpet and remove those carpet tack strips. But for now, we're just gonna focus on the actual laminate floor installation. So you wanna start by having a nice clean surface that's super flat and level. So you wanna check this before you start your installation process. First, let's go over supplies. Here's what you'll need. Of course, you're going to need your laminate flooring. We are using Pergo Outlast, and this is the vintage pewter oak color. Then you will need underlayment. This is crucial for moisture and sound protection, so don't want to miss that. Then to cut the flooring, we used a miter saw and a square and pencil. You can also use a laminate cutter if you don't have a miter saw around. You'll also need some spacers. These will go around the edge of the room to provide an expansion gap needed for laminate flooring. Then you will need tape for the seams of your underlayment. Then you'll need a flooring mallet, a block, and a pole bar. Sometimes these are sold together in a flooring kit. You'll definitely need knee pads because you're gonna be spending a lot of time on your knees. Now, you'll notice here that our kids are helping us. Laminate flooring is one of those projects that can be a great family project. So they can definitely help out. Some things they can do is clean up the dust and debris, hand you supplies, put spacers in around the room for the expansion gap, unpack the laminate from the boxes and hand it to you. Those are just a few things that your kids can do to help with this project. Our kids have grown up watching us renovate over the years, so they are used to the constant projects around here, and any way that we can ever involve them in a project, we jump at the chance to do that. And laminate is a great one because there's not a lot of power tools out and about, so it's relatively safe and the kids can help out. All right, now let's jump into the actual step-by-step process. Before you get started, you definitely need to acclimate the flooring in the room for at least 48 hours. That's an important step, you don't want to miss that. And then, of course, you need to make sure that the floor is level, and then you can start putting in that underlayment. That's the blue stuff. We usually install about one or two rows max of the underlayment at one time. It's just to make it a little easier so it doesn't get damaged as we're working. And then on any of the seams, you want to use the seam tape. That's the red tape, not regular tape. Be sure to use seam tape. You'll notice here that we have the underlayment going up on the edges of the wall, just a couple of inches. You'll trim off the excess later. And this underlayment that we are using has a peel and stick kind of edge where the different rows meet. So you want to be sure to just get that laying nice and flat underneath your laminate. Now, the laminate on the edges of the room where it meets the wall, you need to have spacers in. This is to allow for an expansion gap for the laminate to just naturally expand and contract over time, which it will do. That gap needs to measure approximately 3/8 of an inch. So with that underlayment, you can cut around anything that you'll be installing the flooring around. For instance, we have this fireplace that we have in our living room, and we needed to just cut the laminate or underlayment around it. So you just cut it with an X-Acto knife. It works great. And then for the actual installation of the Pergo Outlast flooring, we found that it worked easiest to put two horizontal pieces together just by interlocking the short edge, and then use just a slight angle and insert it into the top groove of the other plank and just push it in until the edges meet. And then once the edges meet, you can just push down and towards that top plank to lock it into place. You should be able to kind of jam it into place, as you see there, just by using your hands. But if you want some extra oomph behind it, you can certainly use a tapping block and a hammer to make sure all of the joints are nice and snug. You can see here, we're using that tapping block to protect the edge there, and then the hammer and making sure all of those short edges, all the joints are firmly locked into place and there's no gap in between the edges. Here it is again, you just insert the piece at a slight angle so you can see the top is secured, and then you push into place with a little bit of force and then follow up on the short edge with your tapping block and a hammer just to make sure. And just be pretty careful on this because you don't want to damage the edge of the tongue groove. Now, when it comes time to work on the edges, you want to flip the entire plank around so that your tongue and groove doesn't get messed up. And then you can take a pencil and mark the overlap of the two planks. And then this is the side that you need to cut off. And to cut it, we used a miter saw. Once you take it over to your miter saw, you want to use a square to make your line go all the way across the piece of laminate so that you can get it nice and straight. If you don't have a miter saw or you don't want to use a miter saw, they also make laminate cutters. You don't have to walk back and forth into the garage for this. You could just leave it in the actual space that you're installing. So that may be something you want to look into. Now, once you get the piece cut and it comes time to install it along the edge wall, you'll notice there's no room for that tapping block to get in there to get that joint locked. So what you want to do here is use this pull bar. And you'll see here that the edge of the pull bar has a slight lip to it that you'll put on the edge of the plank there. And then we hold that down with our foot while we tap with the hammer. So that just keeps it all locked into place. And you just want to make sure all of your joints, the short edge joints especially, are locked in before you move on. Now the last row of your laminate is always going to take the longest. You want to be sure to just measure the amount of space that you're going to need to fill and then make a line on the actual laminate. And then to cut it, we used a jigsaw to make that cut. That's probably the easiest way to do it. You'll see here, just carefully cutting along that line with a jigsaw to get the correct width to the last row of laminate flooring. Now, once it's cut and ready to go, you can bring it back inside and you want to push the laminate flooring into that last row. And then again, you'll use that pull bar and flooring hammer, just like you did on that edge piece back in the previous step, to pull it nice and tight. Last but not least, after all of the flooring is installed, you can remove those spacers. Just be careful when you do that not to chip the floor. And then you can, of course, put the baseboards back on with a nail gun. I hope you guys enjoyed this process of how to install the Pergo Outlast flooring. Again, this is the vintage pewter oak color from Pergo, and we absolutely love it. I love how it turned out. If you guys have any other questions about laminate flooring or just the installation process, let us know in the comments below. I'd be happy to help you out and answer those for you. And we have a ton more details about the process over in our blog post, which I'm linking in the video description below. Again, hope you guys enjoyed this video. While you're here, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We share tons of renovating and DIY tips, and check out these videos. Hope you guys have a great day.